Welcome to the Motown Minute. In the 1950s, Detroit, Michigan had already been established as the Motor City, housing the top three automobile manufacturers of that time. But on January 12, 1959, another Detroit factory appeared. Where the big three produced automobiles, Motown assembled the soul and pop classics that changed America. Arriving at the height of the civil rights movement, Motown was a black-owned, black-centered business that gave white America something that they just could not get enough of. Joyous, sad, romantic, mad, grooving and moving music. Motown was founded by former boxer and automobile worker Berry Gordy. Gordy was also a songwriter who, at the urging of fellow songwriter Smokey Robinson, decided to establish Motown Records. Robinson produced, wrote, and sang several of Motown's most memorable hits, including the label's first smash song, Shop Around, in 1960. A year later, Please, Mr. Postman by the Marvelettes was the label's first number one song. It would not be the last. Over the next decade, the sheer number of chart-topping artists, musicians, and groups produced by Motown defied comprehension. Martha and the Vandellas, Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, The Temptations, The Four Tops, Diana Ross and the Supremes, Gladys Knight and the Pips, The Jackson 5, Stevie Wonder, and Marvin Gaye. All became part of what would become to known as the Motown sound. It is rumored that Gordy modeled his hit factory after the Detroit car assembly line that he knew so well. Make a good product, then make something similar, and make it quick. Over here were the songwriters, Robinson and the team Holland, Dozier, and Holland. Over there was the talent, the young Stevie Wonder, Marvin Gaye, and above all, Diana Ross. In the neglected corner were the session musicians known as the Funk Brothers, who played on God knows how many hit songs. Let's just say, a lot. So what was the Motown sound? Great melodies, lots of tambourines and hand clapping, blaring horns, interplay between the lead singer and his or her backup vocalists, driving bass lines, and foot-slapping big drum parts. Throughout the 60s, Motown produced a catalog of songs that can't be rivaled. They were simple love songs that told simple stories, often in joyously happy or heartbreakingly sad ways. And all the while, Motown was the pride of Detroit and the pride of Black America. Around the time of the 67 Detroit riots, however, things changed, as they eventually had to. The songwriting trio of Holland, Dozier, and Holland broke off from Motown. And while the Jackson 5 was on the rise, most of the rocksteady Motown acts of the early 60s were on the way out. In 1972, Berry Gordy looked west, and Motown deserted Detroit for L.A. It was arguably the last great burst of Motown creativity. Gordy, distracted by Hollywood, released two films starring Diana Ross. The 80s brought Rick James and Lionel Richie and The Big Chill, a white yuppie film with an amazing Motown soundtrack. By 1988, Gordy had had enough. He sold the company to MCA, which in turn sold it to PolyGram, which in turn was bought out by Universal. Really though, who cares who owns it now? Just pop on one of those numerous greatest hits albums and recall the glory of Motown. The music just doesn't sound 60 years old at all.